self-righteous bitch.
Get out!
Of you.
Shut up. You're not really real. It's not possible. Go away! I'm not gonna let you in! Just go away! You can't come in! I won't let you in!
Bianca? Bianca? Just look at me.
Please, no.
You see,
no.
It's just me. What? What is it?
No.
What's going on? This is not the first time I found you like this.
What? Are you keeping track of me now?
No, of course not.
Okay, so?
So, something is obviously going on with you, and I'd like you to tell me what it is.
I told you.
Yes, you told me. It's nothing. But that can't possibly be true.
I'm fine.
This is not fine, Bianca. Look at you. I mean, you're tired. You look pale. I mean, you've got circles, dark circles under your eyes.
Well, I just woke up. That's all.
Your breathing is shallow.
Yeah, well, David, you scared me when you grabbed me like that.
What was the last time you had something to eat, Bianca?
Oh. That is none of your business.
Bianca. You know how dangerous it is for you to skip meals. You cannot do that. Come on, please, don't shut me out. You know that I care about you.
You know what, David? Who asked you to? I didn't ask you to come here. I didn't say to come in. As a matter of fact, David, I want you to leave now. Just go. Just get the hell out of here, okay?
What are you doing?
I'm taking your pulse.
What happened?
You fainted.
Why?
My guess? It's most likely exhaustion, dehydration, sleep deprivation, probably even emotional. Any one of those in and of themselves would concern me. Bianca, I'd like to take you to the clinic. I want to run some tests.
No, I don't need any tests.
Bianca, at the very least, you need to be examined.
I said no, okay?
Anyone who knows you could see that there's something wrong. Bianca, please, let me help you. Let me find out what's wrong.
Why does there have to be something wrong with me?
That's not what I meant.
You know what, David? Don't you have anything better to do?
This is what I do.
You harass people?
Bianca, I came by today to see how you were doing because I was worried about you. And I'm glad I did.
David, I'm an adult. I'm a grown woman. And I think that I can decide when I need to see a doctor or not. So right now, I would like for you to leave.
All right, fine. You won't listen to me? I'm sure your mother will.
What? No, you can't call my mother.
Why not?
Because.
Why not?
Because she's in the middle of planning her wedding.
Well, something tells me that she'll be happy to put her seating arrangements aside for a second when I tell her that I'm worried about you and that you haven't been eating.
David, there is nothing wrong with
Bianca.
David, it is her wedding to Uncle Jack. Why can't you just let her?
I'm sorry, Bianca. I can't turn away. Not this time.
I'm fine.
I wish that were true. And telling me that your mother is too busy is not going to stop me from calling her. There is nothing more important to a parent than their child's welfare. Now, I'm sorry, but I'm afraid for you right now, Bianca. So please, just hand over the phone so I can call your mother.
All right. If I go with you to the clinic, do you promise me that you won't tell my mother?
Yes. You can trust me, Bianca. You know that.
Promise me.
I promise. All right, Bianca. We're going to run this like a regular physical, okay? Once you change into your gown, Carol will weigh you. She'll take your blood pressure, your temperature. And when that's finished, I'll come back. I'll examine you myself. We'll do an EKG, some blood work, try to figure out why you fainted. No matter what this is, Bianca, I don't want you to worry. We're going to get through this together. No matter what, you're not alone.
Okay.
I'll be right back. Carol, take good care of her.
Here you go, Bianca. You can put your clothes on that chair over there. I'll give you a minute to change, and then we can get started.
We're gonna get through this together. No matter what, you are not alone. Bianca, you're ready. Carol? Where's Miss Montgomery?
I just stepped out to give her some privacy.
We have to find her now.
She looks at you, her wedding to Jack. Everything would change and it would all be your fault.
Stop it. Stop saying that. my stuff. Just get out of my head.
I can't do that. I'm a part of you now. Nobody here but us, and nobody else can hear you.
Stop it. Stop it. Stay away from me.
I'm not going anywhere. It's you and me forever.
Leave me alone, please.
Come on, don't be that way, Bianca. Don't fight me.
Don't touch me. Don't touch me, please.
Bianca, it's me! It's me, David!
Oh my god, David! Oh my god!
It's okay. It's okay. I've got you. You're safe. I won't let you go.
David!
Whatever this is, whatever's going on with you, I'm gonna help you through this, alright? Alright?
Thank God you were here. That was close.
Close?
Yeah. David, thank you. Thank you for your help. I gotta go. I gotta get out of here.
Wait a minute.
What?
Do you know where you are?
Yeah, of course. David, come on. I lost my balance. I'm not crazy.
Bianca? I brought you to the clinic to check you out because you had fainted. Your heart rate was elevated, you look like hell. And then you skipped the examination and you came up here. Why? What's going on with you?
I needed air, David. What?
That's the best you can do?
The best I can do? You know, I hate hospitals. I hate clinics. The smell, I just had to get out of that room.
What's wrong with the front door?
It's nice up here, okay? There's a view, there's a breeze, it's quiet. For God's sake, David, I just needed a minute to myself, okay?
Oh, that does cause you to come up here and dance at the edge of the roof?
Can we just drop
this? No, we can't drop this, Bianca. Not until you tell me what is going on.
There's nothing going on, okay? I'm sorry. I've been very busy, and I'm stressed out.
All right, that's it. Our deal is off. You leave me no choice. I'm taking you to Erica.
David, I really wish that you wouldn't threaten me.
That is not a threat, Bianca. It's a done deal. And we both know that your mother is not going to stop until she gets the truth out of you.
Look, David, I appreciate your concern. I really do, but you're just...
You're afraid. You're afraid to tell Erica about this. Why?
It's just stress. That's all it is. And I'll tell you something, the last thing that my mom needs is another thing to deal with right now.
That's what mothers are for, Bianca. To help you through these type of things.
Have you seen my mother lately? She's getting married, David. She's planning the wedding of the millennium. After losing Chris and almost losing Uncle Jack, she has finally found peace, and I'm not going to mess that up with...
Mess that up with what?
A misunderstanding.
A misunderstanding?
Yes.
Is that what you're calling this?
Yes.
Well, you were just about to do a belly flop off this roof.
I lost my balance,
David. Oh, come on, Bianca. You were fighting me.
Well, you startled me.
No, you did not want me to save you.
Well, I don't need saving, okay?
I know what it's like to stand on the brink. When Leora died, I wanted to bury the pain any way that I could.
I'm sorry you lost her, David. I really am. But you're wrong about me.
Bianca, listen to me. These last couple of years, I have seen you grow into an incredible young woman. You expect me to just stand by and do nothing when it's obvious to me that you are in pain.
I'm not
gonna let you kill yourself, Bianca. I can't. can't lose another little girl. I can't.
David, I don't want to kill myself. I swear it. I want to live.
You want to live? Then why'd you push me away when I grabbed you?
I panicked. That's all, David. David, come on. I would pitch myself off a roof right before my mother gets married?
That's exactly the way it looked like to
me. Well, I would never do that to her. Or to myself. Okay? God damn it, you know, I have too much going on in my life right now to off myself. I have a great family. Friends, a career, school. There is even a woman who's in love with me. And we have plans, David. We have real plans. She wants to show me Europe. She wants us to follow our hearts. I want it too.
I'm happy you finally found love, Bianca. But you can't ask me to turn a blind eye from what I've been seeing from you lately. When I approached you in the park, you nearly jumped out of your skin. And then at Myrtle's, you fainted. And then this? Bianca, come on. Please, don't hide from me. Let me help you.
Like you couldn't help Leora? I mean, that's what you meant, isn't it? When you said that you couldn't lose another little girl? I'm not Leora, David. I'm someone else's daughter. David, I don't mean to hurt you. You have been nothing but kind to me. I don't need your help.
You're not going to tell me what's wrong. All right. At least come downstairs and let me examine
you. Look, I have a date, okay, with Lena, and I don't want to be late.
Travel brochures, flight schedules.
Right, something like that.
All right, look, do me a favor. All right, if you're not going to let me examine you, at least see your own doctor.
I will.
By tomorrow.
Okay, I promise. Can I go now?
If you're taking the stairs.
Thank you, David.
One more thing, Bianca. Please take care of yourself, all right? Eat something, get some sleep.
Okay, I will.
You better. 'Cause I'm gonna check up on you.